Hey guys, and welcome back to another video. So you guys seem to really enjoy my first eye painting video. Many of you actually recreated it, which is awesome, and you've requested a part two, so here it is. And this painting is actually a collaboration that I did with Selma Arts on Instagram, and I will link her page down below so that you guys could check out her version of the eye. I got the original reference from Pinterest. If you're interested, I will also link that down below so that you guys can see where I get my inspiration from. So as usual, I'm starting out with blocks of color in the middle tone and blocking out the highlights and the shadow areas. This is just a really great technique that works so well for me, so I recommend maybe trying it. At this stage, I would also recommend diluting the acrylic paint with water just a little bit so that it's more translucent, as you can still see the sketch marks underneath. Don't worry about the pencil marks, they'll be covered up after a few layers. This is just for that first initial layer. So I start with the middle tone, and then I move on to the highlights, and then the dark shadow areas. And then slowly from there, adding some variants of color, like for example here I'm adding more saturated tones of orange and starting to build up the layers of paint. I also like to add some pink tones so that it doesn't look monotonously orange, and this really helps add dimension to your work. Also, I kind of just always paint with pink. It's weird, I almost get uncomfortable if I don't use pink in a painting, but yeah. By the way, apologies for the change in lighting. I had to film this over 4 separate days just because the weather was not on my side. As you can hear, it started raining one of the times, but yeah. Anyway, so, and then I'm just going to continue building up the layers using the guidelines that I've already made to define the shape even more. Once you're more comfortable with the shape that you've built up, you can start building up more layers to eventually cover up all the pencil marks with the paint. And then you can use a smaller brush to add the details of the shape. However, I accidentally overdid it, which I have a tendency to do sometimes, because I actually wanted this to have more bigger strokes and blocks of colors instead of having small details. So you actually see me going over it with a bigger flat brush to try and simplify it again, so kind of to undo the work that I did. Anyways, so I've asked people on Instagram to ask me questions, so I'm gonna answer them now. The first one is, what inspired you to do art? And honestly, I've been drawing and doodling for as long as I can remember. Literally, there's this baby picture of me where I was doodling before I could even walk, so there's that. And I guess genetic comes to play a little as well, because my great-grandmother was an artist. And my parents have always been very supportive. Next question is, who inspires you? And the person who inspires me most art-wise, and still does to this day, is Minnie Small. I absolutely love and adore her, and I've been watching her for, I think, 3 years now. And she's actually the reason why I started this art account, so huge thanks and shout out to her. I will link her channel down below. You guys are gonna love her. I also really love Jim Reno. I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly. Jim Reno. I discovered her, I think, a year ago, and I was really amazed how we had an incredibly similar art style and aesthetic. And I even had a comment from one of you guys who noticed the same thing, so that we have like a similar art style. So if you're interested in her channel, I will also link her below, because if you like my art, you're definitely gonna love hers. Again, I have to say sorry about the chickens in the background, because I live in a jungle. But anyway, how did you develop your art style? And I think I'll talk about this more in a future video. Honestly, I don't think that my art style is fully developed, and I definitely have phases, but how I developed my current one is I used colors that I liked and painting things that I was drawn to without thinking about it too much, as in without feeling guilty that I'm painting the same things over and over again. For example, I like to use the colors pink and yellow and purple. And I like flowers and I like feminine aesthetics, so I just keep painting that without feeling guilty, like, oh my god, I'm painting the same things over and over again. Just paint what you like, paint what makes you happy, and that'll help you. Okay, so eyelash time. I'm actually terrified of painting eyelashes. Like, how can you not be terrified of painting eyelashes? It's terrifying. Still not the best, but I try. Also, I wanted to add details with white pen, but yeah, that did not work out, so I had to completely wipe that out. Yeah. And let me tell you, I did not expect to have such a difficult time painting the stars, that I ended up just cutting like star-shaped tin foil and glued it on, because my silver paint was not that tinted. So that was a challenge. And I filmed this outside, and I love how the golden hour looked through the trees. I think it just looks really pretty. So yeah, as usual, I'm gonna add some gold ink for the finishing touches and some freckles too. And then I'm just gonna go over it just a little bit around the eyebrows to add a little bit more depth. And that about concludes the painting. Yes, we love a successful tape peel, don't we? So yeah, here's the final piece. I hope you guys enjoyed that. Thank you for the questions. Thank you for the suggestions. Thank you for 700 subs. That's amazing. And yeah, be sure to check out Selma Arts on Instagram and all the lovely people I've linked below. And I will see you in the next one soon. Hopefully soon. By the way, I think that's officially gonna be my outro. Okay, bye.